15 years ago from today, in a government city hospital in New Delhi, the first cry of a newborn echoed through the hospital walls, flooded the corridors, bringing joy to all ears and smiles to all faces. But even before the little baby could open its eyes and catch a glimpse of the new world, a world very different from where he had come from, he himself was caught, captured on the screen of a 2 inches technology. As his dad clicked the newborn's first pic, the flash of the camera frightened the baby, who was presently oblivious to this new technology, which would later on turn out to become his greatest obsession. As an infant, the boy was allowed full liberty and access to this 2 inches of technology, which we commonly call smartphones. Let me take you to a flashback. Back in the 90s, a smartphone was unheard of. Our parents and the previous generation was only equipped with a much smaller version of a smartphone, which was commonly called a mobile phone, the ancestor of the smartphone. The difference between the mobile phone and the smartphone was, the smartphone is well equipped with more advanced technological provisions and facilities, which was absent in a mobile phone. The mobile phone just had a keypad and a call facility. But research suggests, out of 20 jobs we do in a day, 19 of them are dependent on smartphones. However, the growing influence of smartphones on infants and children is a major cause of concern. And why so? Let me tell you. The smartphone gives out microwave radiation, which degenerates, deteriorates the neurons or the brain cells, and the absorption capacity is much higher in children and infants when compared to adults, which poses a risk of brain cancer as observed in most cases. We often see children and infants enraptured, fascinated, captivated by this new technology, but it comes with a price. We all have fears, and I'm sure you have your fears too. For example, I'm claustrophobic. I have fear of closed spaces. And many of you have different fears. Fear of failure, fear of exams, fear of marks, and so on and on. But there is one fear that we all suffer from. And that fear is called nomophobia, which is the fear and anxiety of not having your phone around you. The overuse of smartphone is triggered by the variety and the diverse choices provided by it, offered by it. But do these facilities come for free? You might say, or you might think, it hardly takes 10 seconds to download an app from Google Play Store and you can use it for the rest of your life. It doesn't cost much, but it costs much more than all the riches in the world. It costs you your health, your capabilities, your peace of mind, and much more potential that you have in you. The main causes why smartphones are used mostly in and around the world, despite having been used for centuries, are social media, Instagram, WhatsApp, and more, overexposure to information and data, internet pornography, that is something very common in most adolescents and teenagers all over the world, which is not only a source of distraction, but also pollutes the mind. I can see many of you smiling. Shopping, gambling, stock trading, and so on and on. There was a time long back, if you see the black and white movies, you see women carrying bags and bags of vegetables and groceries from the market. But today, we have Swiggy, we have Zomato, and I'm sure there'll be a time in the future where people will only hear about this room called kitchen in the house, and they'll read about it in history books. This statistical data shows the addiction of smartphones in about 12 years, starting from January 1, 2004 to March 2016, and the ascending graph very evidently proves all the facts stated by me previously. Coming to smartphones and adolescents, there's this one meme that is very popularly circulated all over social media, that shows two different scenarios, two different eras. One is in the 90s and one is post-90s, that is the present generation. And the 90s scenario shows a child who's playing in the hot sun and he's being forcefully dragged into the house by his mother who wants him to sit and study. And the 2000s generation shows a completely different scenario where the child is busy studying within the house, the child is busy on tablets and phones within the house, and he's being pushed by the mother outside the house who wants him to go and enjoy nature, play in the sun, live with nature. This only shows how much things have changed in 20 years. This is the data regarding the effect of smartphones on adolescents. About 67% of adolescents have been noted to have distractions from phones, negative emotional effects by their teachers in and around the world. There's this one scene that happens in every house, and I'm sure it happens in yours too, where the book is in front of you, you're glancing through the pages, but your eyes are on the phone waiting for a notification to pop up on the screen any minute. Your ears are waiting impatiently for the phone to beep. And your mind is thinking, why isn't my friend texting me? It's been 2 minutes since we spoke. What's he busy doing? But the book in front of you would never catch your attention. And this is very common. I myself have done this before. This is very common and we see it almost everywhere. I would like to draw your attention to the second last point, which says that teens who spend 5 hours a day on their phones have been detected with sleep disorders and many other problems, diseases such as high blood pressure and weight gain, which are not commonly seen in growing children, which are commonly seen in older people, but they are still visible in kids of our age only because of overuse of smartphones. There are some ways to prevent the use of smartphones, overuse, mind you, of smartphones at home. And these have to be inculcated into the children, and also steps have to be taken by the adults of the house. The first and foremost being, use apps to monitor the duration and the nature of the use of the smartphone by the children. The second being, manage your own use. Often adults who are themselves preoccupied with their lives and their jobs and hectic schedule don't spend enough time on their children and don't get involved in their children's lives, because of which the children become heavily dependent on the smartphones. So one thing is the adults should themselves minimize the use of smartphones and focus more on their children. The third being, there should be rules around the house. This is not very necessary if the child himself has a realization of what is his priority and what is not his priority. The fourth being, other interests. Before the invention of smartphones and mobile phones and before technology came into existence, kids used to play outside in the hot sun, climbing trees, doing other hobbies, drawing, painting, art, learning dancing, singing. By nurturing these hobbies, not only the child experiences his potential, he understands his potential, he becomes more creative, but also the distraction of phones can be eliminated from his life. The last being communication. Communication as in, there should be a lot of talk between the adult members of the family, between the grandparents of the family and the children of the family, and they can share everything they feel, everything they think, their opinions, their views, anything that they want to say freely without feeling restrained or constricted. So communication is something very important, I feel, that should be used to eliminate the use of smartphones. And this is another meme that is very popularly circulated on social media. The use of selfies. And like I said, a child born in the hospital is first captured on a screen of a mobile phone or of a smartphone before he himself sees the world. This is something that is very commonly see around, and I won't say just women or girls are interested in taking selfies. I've seen a lot of boys also taking selfies. And there's another meme that's very popularly circulated, which says Neil Armstrong took 5 photos and he went on the moon, but girls take 30 photos when they go to the bathroom. So this basically emphasizes on how much we have become addicted to the technology and how much we've become obsessed with how we look. The next being smartphones and family life. When was the last time you had dinner with your family on the table at 8, everybody together, with no phones, no technology, no distractions around. When you're just talking and you're being one, you're being together, you're feeling belonging, I mean, you're feeling a sense, you're having a sense of belonging to each other, you're feeling oneness, love, affection. The last time this happened in my house was when the Wi-Fi was down. So again, when all the members of the family get busy in using smartphones and don't have time to spend with each other, it often leads to communication gap, as I stated before, which again has further harmful effects like thermal effects. The screen of the phone, of the smartphone, radiates a lot of heat. The heat radiated on a smartphone increases the temperature of the skin, and it gradually damages your skin cells. The second being the radiation that is emitted from the smartphone. We're often told not to talk with our smartphones by putting them directly over the ear, and we are supposed to use speakers. That's because the radiation from the smartphone can penetrate the brain and damage the brain cells. It basically reduces your sleeping capacity, your retention, mental retention, your memory power, and a lot more. We are also told not to keep our smartphones in our pockets. That's because the radiations can also have an influence on our reproductive organs, which can lead to sterility or infertility. Next, this is another poster which is circulated to spread awareness regarding how much we've become enslaved by the technology, where it says smartphones are called cell phones because they basically jail us and we are their captives. Another one is basically this image shows how a mobile phone and all the electrical wires have binded us like chains and we've been enslaved by the present technology. And the last one is this evolution of man, which earlier was a Darwin's theory of evolution, which showed how man progressively became man from a monkey, an ape. But this is what presently it is, when a man has turned to technology now, which is the modern day evolution of man. So I would like to end my talk by saying, yes, technology does have a lot of advantages, a lot of benefits, a lot of uses, but everything should be in limited amounts, everything should be minimal, in safe amounts, because as much as it is beneficial to you, it costs you a lot, it comes with a price, so you must limit the amount and use it only in cases of utmost necessity. And we must try to adopt ways where we can spend more time with our friends, family, relatives, and live life the way it is supposed to be lived instead of becoming completely dependent on technology. Thank you.